No sense rubbing it in.
Just a boy. Don't know where he's from, but it must be hard to pronounce.
You know, you should never sneak up on a guy in a dangerous place like... No! What's wrong with your foot?
Probably stepped on a spiniferous thornweed.
Don't worry, I got just the fix for that. Tell me, is it more of a...
Ow! Or a...
Oh, oh! Either way, the Merchant of Miracles has got you covered. But it'll cost you. I've risked my neck to forage the most rare, miraculous, mysterious, and oftentimes delicious ingredients. Ah, here it is. I massage this into my skin twice a day, and just look at my little biscuits. Well, now that I've mulled it over, you'd better not. It might stunt your growth. Ooh, such exquisite material.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. I knew you weren't from around here. Well, you best get going. Yeah. Nobody likes a late night. Oh, wait. You're stuck here with me. Every virgin is out, and my shortcut had a few shortcomings. I swear that rock leaped straight out of the water. Now I'm stuck here with no wheel, a lost toolbox, and Mr. Fancy Cakes. Say, what? I'll bet a fine, strapping young man like you could help me fix up this wheel. Yep, you help me fix my chariot, and I'll give you a lift to the tournament. Hopefully no one else notices your horrible lack of punctuality. Oh, how rude. Do you have any questions for me?
Nope.
Just a little oop here, a little elbow grease there, and...
Oh, can I pet your goats?
Stay away from my majestic unicorns. Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
I just passed up a wheel. How come I didn't pick it up there?
The wheel was very broken. I would have to find another solution.
Okay, so he wants to make one.
If we just move this over to the left, right there a little more, and... Ah, bargain stopper!
Perhaps there was a wheel on the other side of that river. Too bad I couldn't swim.
How did you get across that river?
That missing wheel had me stumped. I had to go out on a limb to get past the root of the problem.
Ugh. Grandpa, your infamous puns are not my favorite.
What's the matter? You don't like the timbre of my voice? You'll warm up to the puns.
These are terrible.
Here, kitty, kitty. Not a kitty! Not a kitty!
No wheels are there. An overgrown patch. The spiniferous thorn weeds obstructed a path to the water well.
The well with the ginormous dragon in it?
Perhaps. I tried to chop down those thorn weeds, but my tiny hatchet was ineffective. I would need a bigger, sharper blade. Square was eerily quiet. Was I the only person in Daventry not at the parade? Bakery, and it smelled delicious. Aha! I didn't see any reason why that stale bread wouldn't work for a wheel. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins. I decided to leave some coins for the bread. The delectable goods looked tasty, but I couldn't compete in this tournament with a full stomach. Like me, this little tree was new in town and needed some time to grow and find its way. What? Too sappy?
I have nothing to say.
You'll warm up to it. Looked like a blacksmith shop of sorts. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins. I borrowed enough for the day.
And then you scooped up all the weapons, right? Right?
No, Gwendolyn, I didn't. I was looking for a wheel, not a fight. I stumbled upon some kind of curiosity shop. Nothing seemed to be brewing yet. I didn't need to borrow more than one wheel.
Actually, see, I grabbed that bread, not knowing that they had other stuff here, so maybe I should put that bread back. And get the wooden table.
I put the bread back and went looking for a new wheel.
Give me my damn money back.
I took my money back. Aha! Something big and round. Hopefully no one would mind if I borrowed this tabletop. Against the knickknacks was a little collection tray with a sign asking for tips. Against the knickknacks was a little collection tray with a sign asking for tips. Decided to leave some coins for the tabletop.
could I squeeze by you gents?
No. We are here to guard the town entrance and keep out any riffraff whilst everyone is watching the parade. If we were to leave, rapscallions would run amok in the empty shops.
Back away, boy. We are on the lookout for intruders.
Huh. I am an intruder. Hello.
A shortcut.
I don't know about that.
Do I really have to hear the story about how you took forever to tiptoe across that fallen tree again?
No, I guess not.
Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
I thought this might do the trick.
What a clever choice! Such craftsmanship! And sturdy, too! Just hope you didn't pay too much. I'd hate for you to have spent all your money when you've only just arrived in town, right? You ready, Mr. Fancy Cakes? I know, darling, I know. Silly question, you were born ready. Oh, wait, before my mind slips, I was able to procure an entrance ticket to the tournament. Since you so graciously found me a wheel, I am more than willing to sell it to you at a reasonably discounted rate. Are you interested?
Oh, sounds good. I love a deal.
So do I, boy, so do I. If I see one, I'll let you know. Here you are. Now, let's vamanusi from this meadowland, Mr. Fancy Cakes. It is go time. Mr. Fancy Cakes! Heel! Halt! Avast! Stop! We sincerely hope you enjoyed your stay in our luxury cabin. Please gather your belongings and watch your head on exit.
Thanks for the hospitality.
No time to lounge, my boy! Lucky for you, the parade is halted. Another case of a mysterious missing bridge, I imagine. Watch your step. We wouldn't want any tears in that illustrious cape. Bon voyage, Buttercup! Don't forget about us working folk. Especially when your pockets are full of riches.
Back away, back away. This area is unsafe for commoners.
Hello. Apologies, I'm late. I should be on the list. First name Graham, last name...
The list, unfortunately, is inside the theater, which is across that bridge, which is inexplicably missing.
We've ordered a temporary fix, but we're still sorting out the work order.
Well, with all the recent budget issues, I remain skeptical about the repairs.
Well, can't those knights check the list?
Do you mean Kyle and Larry? They're off duty. Don't ask.
You needn't worry. These knight hopefuls will figure out a solution soon, and then we can carry on with the auditions.
Well, but I am a hopeful knight. If you just step aside, I'm confident that I could find a way across.
Daventry Decree 6645 states that a royal guard, once commanded, must never, under no circumstances, abandon his post while on duty.
Well, technically, Addendum 237A allows us to leave if someone is in distress and in need of assistance, of a life or death nature.
I stand corrected, and we wouldn't want a repeat of the Rubenstern fiasco. A tardy auditionee, however, hardly counts for distress. Sorry, but we can't leave our post. King's orders.
Would an entrance ticket prove my worth?
Sorry, but the collection of entrance tickets will take place inside the theater.
Come at me, bees!
Those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he...
Stay off those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he was talking.
This tired argument is getting on my nerves.
No need to argue about the fact that I am...
Uh-oh.
Oh, dear. Not good.
Bees!
Bees! Bees!
Over here, buddy.
Another horn and another missing piece.
Give me a second. I have the perfect plan.
This looks like a problem for my assistant. Pardon me!
right. The tree was too heavy to move. I would need to chop it down to size. I left the hatchet lodged in the tree because I would not need it anymore.
Are you sure?
Quite sure. Everyone always asks about that hatchet. It gets a tad annoying.
Oh.
Old school raft. That overkill though. Oh man.
That's Hang crazy. On a sec. Graham, right?
Yes. How did you know my name?
Well, you'd be surprised at the information people give out when they're too busy thinking about their own agenda. I also observed that without you, no one could have made it across. Well done, Graham.
Thanks, I guess.
They'll never acknowledge it, you know. Those who use their minds over their biceps are never woven into the tapestries of time. I can tell you're like me, a creative thinker, an intellectual. To win this competition, you'll need to prove that your talents are more powerful than their strength, agility, and speed. You'll also need a friend.
I could really use a friend.
They call me Manny. Pleased to meet you.
So, friend, what's your favorite color? Do you like popcorn-flavored jelly beans? Because I do. What's your availability for sleepovers? Are we in a secret club?
Green. I prefer pizza-flavored. I'm free on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and I would say more of a secret alliance.
Alliance?
This competition will not be easy, and Daventry needs men like us. If we put our heads together, we might have a shot.
What's the plan?
If you win, put a good word in for me with the king. And if I win, I'll do the same. Soon, we'll both be moving up the ranks in the castle together. We should head inside the theater, though.
Let me know how I can help.
I don't know. Should I trust Manny? He might be the decent guy, but I don't know yet. What am I supposed to do here? All right. Okay, something's not right. Oh, there we go. This is my way up. I don't know why we couldn't go the same way. I mean, it seemed like I could. Or maybe I just assumed that I could.
Graham, to the front of the stage, please. Now that we have recovered our list, it is my duty to inform you that you are officially signed in. Yay. And I do want to apologize. I am very, very terribly sorry. But we've run out of commemorative tote bags.
That's not a problem. I have no use for tote bags. My mother designed my cape with lots of pockets. Is the next event about to start?
Not so fast, Pocket Boy. The tournament bylaws explicitly state that each contestant must complete every event before continuing on in the competition.
Since you were late, you missed the test of chivalry and the welcoming parade. Both designed as light-hearted warm-ups and getting-to-know-you type exercises. You know, an icebreaker, before we start in on the usual death, destruction, and duels of a cutthroat nature.
Don't forget about Amendment 70, Article 4.
I was getting to that, thank you. In the spirit of equal opportunity, the new rules state that you can schedule a make-up chivalry test if and only if the circumstances for your absence were extenuating. So, I will ask, what were your extenuating circumstances that made you late for the tournament?
Well, my mom whipped up a stack of my special choco chip pancakes, and she never lets me leave the house until I finished all my breakfast.
Mm-hmm. I'll just pencil in Mummy's boy. Now, go on, mingle with the other contestants. Find out as much as you can about them, and when you're ready for the chivalry test, come and see me.
When we see your
Thanks for knocking that log over out there. Really, it gave me the opportunity to go on a lovely cruise.
Those nights were annoying me, and I wanted some alone time. Leave me be, little fly. You don't want to wake the bull.
Look, I don't want to be in this conversation any more than you do, but I missed the chivalry test, and I need to make it up. The faster we get this over with, the faster I can leave you alone.
Well, make it quick, then buzz off.
What was that you were hiding in your paws?
Well, none of your business, feather boy.
Seriously, what are you hiding? Is it a snack?
Leave it alone, string bean.
I'm Graham.
No. No last names. I don't even want your first name.
And your name?
I'm known throughout the land as Circumference, but I am currently in the process of rebranding myself. Starting with my name. You should call me Acorn.
I'll leave you be.
Go away!
Treasure that was within. I could feel the riches.
Hey there, I'm Graham.
Charmed, I'm sure.
And your name?
What?
Well, I didn't catch your name.
What? Is this true? Surely you jest, Greg. What rock did you crawl out from? How do you not recognize this well-proportioned face?
Well, it's not Greg, it's Graham. And, of course, I know who you are. You're... every woman's dream?
Well, you got that right. The ladies love... Who? Who do they love, Gabe?
It's not Gabe, it's... oh, never mind. Yes, your name... you are... you're...
Alright, so... Sir Ten himself. Oh, I have to wait, I'll be right back.
Sir Ten of himself.
Cheeky. But now you're starting to bother me, Grant.
I couldn't help it. No, but seriously, you're... that jerk who pushed me into the river.
Oh, yes, that silly feather does look familiar. Look at it. Like a limp piece of cheese.